I'm here at the Robert Garcia Boxing Academy in Oxnard, shooting another episode of the Robert Garcia Reality Show. Check it out. So tell us, Mikey Garcia has been interviewed right now?
Yeah, he's being interviewed by a Russian lady, a Russian reporter, so it's pretty cool.
He's a big star now, huh?
Yeah, Mikey's doing a great job. You know, I'm honored and proud of him that, you know, he's my uncle, you know? He's close for a world title and another one from Oxnard. You know, Robert, his brother, did it, so my uncle, another uncle, so it's good, man. It's good to be in the family business.
What's up?
I've got my own scooter.
Where's Robert?
I'm over here.
I was gonna give you your first Russian lesson really quick.
Russian lesson? I already said, well, what did I say?
You said, Иди сюда.
Иди сюда.
Как дела? And
я тебя люблю.
Я тебя люблю. I love you.
Hey, they're gonna make you say I'm a bitch.
How do you say I'm a bitch?
Сука.
And when you look at a fighter like Brandon Rios, 28-0, 21 knockouts. What do you think about him as a fighter?
Brandon Rios, ¿qué piensas de él como peleador?
Es un buen peleador, es un guerrero, un peleador que le va a sacar un susto a todos los que le pongan.
He's a warrior. He's got a lot of heart. He's gonna put a lot of pressure, obviously, you know, that's what he does, so he's gonna put a scare on any opponent they put in front of him.
Does he remind you anyone in the history of boxing that you could say, wow, he reminds me?
Le recuerda, Brandon, algunos peleador que usted se acuerde de en otra época, en otro tiempo, a otro peleador que Brandon le recuerda a usted que diga, Brandon pelea como aquel o algo así.
Pues, sí, ha habido muchos que tienen ese estilo, como el estilo de él lo tenía. El mismo Manos de Piedra peleaba de esa manera, pura presión.
You know, similar style to compared to Durant, you know, Manos de Piedra, Durant, Hands of Stone, you know, just a lot of pressure and hit really, really hard and, you know, keep coming forward.
Hands of Stone and a head like a rock.
Yeah. Yeah,
now, you're a fighter. You're an outstanding fighter. Robert was a fighter who won a world title. The Klitschko brothers told me they would never fight for any amount of money. Would you ever fight Robert if someone offered 50 million, 100 million?
I tell Robert, let's take it and we'll just take it easy on each other. Let's get a payday. Nah, that wouldn't happen. I don't think that would happen ever with any brothers.
We just talked about you. We said such nice things that you're like Roberto Duran, hands of stone, and I said he has a brain like a rock.
Do an interview on him, fucking. Ese güey está pendejo a la verga. Nomás quiere pichi cosas. Dile mal, pichi, él y puto. Neta, es un puto ese güey.
You have your reporter from Russia. You have Pelos. You have a reporter. Where's Christina? What country is she from?
She's mixed. Like her,
she's got like 20.
Yeah, like her dad is like Mexican,
German, Mexican, Filipino.
And then you have him. He's shooting a documentary here.
Anytime. This is your house. So, yeah, we get people like Ellie here every day. Why wouldn't we want you here?
Well, people like Ellie make it okay for people like me to come here.
You guys like Nonito Donair?
Yeah,
I've been in San Francisco and на прошлом конференции. She just came back from San Francisco from the last France conference, and she met with him there.
Why
did you? Yeah,
she wanna see him fight in Pacquiao one day.
Oh, that'll be a good fight.
Yeah.
So, Who is the number one fighter in Russia right now? Not the Ukraine, in Russia. Is it Pirov?
Russia?
Yeah, Dmitry?
Dmitry Pirov.
And he could beat every...
Maxim Vlasov.
Oh yeah, Maxim Vlasov, great.
Maxim, I met him, big guy. He was in the Olympics.
You know,
yeah, I know Maxim.
I am manager Maxim.
Oh, he's a good guy. The ladies, how do you say it?
No. I want to know something to say to
the ladies. Oh, Pelos wants to know something to say to the ladies in Russian. What should he know?
Nothing what you just say, trust me.
None of what he was talking about now. Yeah.
I want to like something clever, something
clever.
Clever. Or something, something that.
Yes, you are beautiful.
Atlishna.
What does that mean?
You are beautiful.
Krasivaya.
He looks like he's Uzbeki. You look like you're from
Uzbekistan.
No, he looks like Kazakhstan.
Tajikistan.
Dushanbe. I interviewed Brandon Krause. He's a trainer at a gym. It's Outlaws. And I asked him, Brandon, who are the 5 top trainers in boxing? And he put you as number 1. I think he put Freddie as number 2, then Nazim.
Trainers?
Yeah.
Who put me as number 1?
Brandon Krause of Alba Rival.
Fuck. That's something? Never heard that before. Hey, you know what? Let's be real. You know, Freddie Roach has done a lot in the sport. He has the best fighter in the world right now, and he's done a great job with him. And he's also done a great job with the rest of his fighters, you know. But just Pacquiao himself is somebody that you know, you got to at least admit, you know, that they've done a great job. You know, I can't say no. And if somebody else thinks I'm doing a great job, because I not only have, you know, 1 fighter, I have 4, 5, you know, 12 you guys are coming up, and they're all winning. We haven't lost. Well, then, you know, those that know about it and want to consider me up there too, well, thanks for thinking that way.
So Robert, you ready for Nonito Donaire, 20 seconds?
Yeah, I'm ready for Oscar Diaz, fights tonight, Orange County.
Yeah. What does he look like? Which one is Oscar?
Pro. He's a left-hander, he's turning pro today.
Oh!
Shut the fuck up, bitch, we're doing an interview.
I'm sorry, did somebody say something? I didn't hear anybody. So you guys are going off to fight now?
Yeah. Look, Oscar's going to wear Brandon's outfit.
Oh, that's really cool. Congratulations.
No. Fucking Brandon, this is his fight. It's still here.
Oh.
Like, it's up to you and it's still there. Fucking Brandon, don't pick it up. His belt was here too. He just got it like, because he went to that parade. That's why he got it. It was still here.
So Robert, any message to your fans? They're going to see you all in New York in about 1 week?
I'll be there Monday.
You'll be there Monday? You ready?
I'll be there Monday, and then I'll be back again a week before December 3rd.
What's your prediction for Nonito fight?
You know, hey, I'm not fighters. I never make predictions because you know, they all have hard fights. It's world championship fights, so we're fighting great fighters. But, Nonito's in great shape. So.
Hey.
Come on.
Me peso.
Carlos, you know what the first thing he told me when I walked into the gym today? What is the first thing you told me when I walked into the gym today?
What'd you say when he came in?
He's a bitch.
And then what did you tell me afterwards?
Courtesy of Brandon Reels right here.
What did you tell me afterwards?
Didn't you yell out,
Ellie said that.
And then what did you say, that I'm
Could I have a new scooter?
You have a new scooter, and you said that I'm a hoe.
Called you a hoe?
Yeah, 3 times, you remember? What did you tell me, Julian? You said...
Hey, he knows his colors for a 3-year-old.
Yeah.
He knows how to count to 20.
You know how to count to 20? Let me hear.
Say, go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Keep going.
What are your classmates?
12, 13, 14, 15, 18, 19, 20.
So there you have it, another episode of the Robert Garcia Reality Show. Stay tuned for more. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekback reporting.